But who is this Chester? So when I put this face on this, this is, Tolle would say in his book that if you can create a space of observance, when you can actually view this part of yourself that is not who you really want to be, this part of yourself that makes a fool of yourself all the time, that reacts in fear, that jumps to conclusions, that accuses, that assumes, that does all these things, when you realize that, true, you're capable of that, but that's not who you have to be. And when I realized that and created that space and saw this person in the corner and understood that with awareness, that as soon as I had an awareness of that, that was the beginning of the answer. Because when you have an awareness of it, then you've stopped identifying with it, and then you're not the victim of that experience anymore. I want to live a life of joy, a life that is without fear, that's without that knee-jerk reaction, that is soaring. And some of you may know, I fly. I love to fly. Jackson's keeping me too busy to fly. But I love to fly. My sister gave me the gift of an intro flight back in 1990, I think it was, in a little Cessna 150. And, you know, I took that flight, and it didn't really sink in that I could actually do that. And the years went by, and the kids came along, and braces to be purchased, and private school tuition to pay. And then eventually one day I couldn't stand it any longer, made the mistake one day of sitting in a helicopter down at the Northwest Aviation Show, which is next weekend, by the way, Gallup Fairground. Bright yellow, this helicopter, you know, obviously painted to ensnare helpless fools like myself. And I sat in that helicopter, and it just all made sense. And I realized that I was meant to soar in life. I wasn't meant to scrabble along into death.
Let's give a big standing ovation.